my dear students. Now next topic we will see the same chapter number 4, our body. Our next topic is the circulatory system. How the things circulate in our body. How transportation of substance is going on. The circulatory system is responsible for transportation of substances to and from various parts of our body. This system comprises of heart, blood and blood vessels. So first we will see here a very simple structure of heart. The heart is a hollow cone-shaped muscles located between the lungs and behind the sternum. It is located between the lungs and behind the sternum. It is located a little of the left and middle of our chest and is about the size of our fist. Fist means like this. Its size is like this of our fist. The heart is divided lengthwise into two parts by a muscular wall. This lining is called the muscular wall. By this muscular wall, it is divided into two parts. Each half is divided into upper and lower chambers by walls. The walls allow the flow of blood into one direction only. The upper two chambers are called auricles. These two chambers are called auricles. And the lower two chambers, this is called ventricles. The function of the heart is to pump blood throughout the body. What is the function of heart? It is helping into pump the blood throughout the body. The next topic is blood. Blood is a red color fluid which flows inside the blood vessels. It is having a liquid part, cells of different kind. The red blood RBCs carry oxygen from the lungs to different parts of the body. They also help to remove carbon dioxide from the body. The white blood cells WBC help to fight infection. There are another type of blood cells that help in clotting of blood. These cells are called platelets. The liquid portion of the blood dissolves nutrients and other substances that are required by other parts of body and transport them to those parts. Similarly, it carries away the waste material from different parts of the body. So these are the function of blood. Now we will see the next one, that is blood vessels. Here you can see one picture, a rough diagram of one body structure in which we have to concentrate on blood vessels. These blood vessels, arteries and vein, blood flow throughout the body through a network fine tube that are called blood vessels. There are three types of blood vessels: arteries, veins and capillaries. The blood vessels that carries oxygen, rich blood from the heart to different parts, it's called arteries. The blood vessels that carry oxygen, deflected blood from different parts of the body to the heart are called veins. When arteries reach an organ, they branch into very fine tubes, it's called capillaries. The capillaries help to blood to carry blood to every cell of the body in order to supply it with oxygen and nutrients. When the blood leaves an organ, capillaries join together to form a larger and larger vessels and ultimately form a vein. Here in this picture also you can see this structure in which arteries and veins are showing. The circulation of blood, the movement here, circulation of blood, we can see here this circulation of blood. About this, the movement of the blood The movement of blood through the heart and around the body is called circulation, and circulation of blood is take place by the following manner. It is depend on the function of heart. The left side of heart pump out oxygen rich blood that is supporting to the body parts. The body takes oxygen from the blood and uses it in turn and releases carbon dioxide and waste into blood. The returning blood enters the right auricle, which pours into the right ventricle. Blood is pumped through the lung by the right ventricle for removal of carbon dioxide and enrichment with oxygen. The oxygen-rich blood now enters the heart again through the left auricle, and the process continues. Ventricle, auricle. This is left auricle, this is right auricle. This is left ventricle, this is right ventricle. Now, the next topic and the last topic of this chapter, that is heart sound. Student, do you know which instrument is this? I hope you have seen this. Might be you have gone to doctor sometime, so you have seen this type of instrument doctors having. This instrument is called stethoscope. The heart relaxes and contracts while pumping. Heart is relaxing and contracting while pumping. Something is doing in heart. Something is going on in our heart. Some movements are there. This relaxation and contraction of heart is known as heartbeat. We can feel our heartbeat by placing our hand on the left side of our chest. When we will do this process, keep your palm on the left side of your heart. This heart side, left side of your body, keep left side of your chest, your heart, it is there. Keep your hand palm there and feel this. The heartbeat of an adult human at rest is between 65 to 75 per minute. It increases when a person is doing some physical activity. We can listen our heartbeat clearly with the help of instrument called a stethoscope. We can listen carefully that the lubbed up sound of our heart sound with the help of this stethoscope. So I hope, student, you have understood about heart and blood vessels and this heart sound. Read this chapter carefully.